to our 11th annual Fauquier County Public Schools Division Spelling Bee. I'm Steve Payne, the English and Reading Supervisor for Fauquier, and it's an honor for me to welcome student participants, parents, and all other supporters who help prepare participants and who are here cheering them on today. The names of the 48 winners of each of the school level Bees are printed as participants in today's division-wide program. You all deserve congratulations for your achievements and for reaching this round of competition. Let's give them a big round of applause. I'd like to recognize and thank our school level B coordinators for your coaching efforts. Would you all stand so that we can recognize you? If you're a school level coordinator, thank you all. Thank you, Ms. Ruth Nelson, the principal of Taylor Middle School, for providing our venue. Thank you, in fact, to all elementary and middle school principals for supporting Bees at your schools. Thank you, Mr. Bob Rankin, for recording the event for the Division YouTube channel. And finally, a special thanks to Mr. John Lewis for your continued faithful commitment to and hard work as our Division Bee organizer. And special thanks to my assistant, Ms. Nancy Singstack, for her behind-the-scenes magic. And since no spelling bee is complete without excellent judges and pronouncers, I'm pleased to welcome and thank our judging panel, including the chairman of the school board, Mr. Brian Gorg, school board vice chairman, Mr. Duke Bland, and our school superintendent, Dr. Dave Jack. Thank you all very much. And finally, it's a pleasure to welcome back Dr. Eileen Burguin, who's acting now as Assistant Superintendent for Instruction, and she's our retired English and Reading Supervisor and will serve as our pronouncer today. Thank you for joining us. Again, welcome everyone and good luck to our participants. I just have a few protocols to go over as we get started. Please silence your cell phones. Students should give their devices to their parents. I hope they've already taken care of that. Please disable your flash on your cameras or cell phones after the first round. We're going to allow flash photography up until the second round begins. During round one, students will come to the microphone to pronounce and spell their first names to become accustomed to the microphone. You may use flashes for round one only. Please no talking during rounds, and that goes for the participants as well, please, especially the participants. The noise is very distracting, and limit conversation between rounds as much as possible to keep the rounds moving smoothly. Each speller who misses a word will leave the stage at the end of the round. At that time, those spellers will go to the hospitality room, which is down the main hall, where they will return their name badges for reuse, receive their certificates, and get refreshments. The winner's name will be engraved on the trophy, which is on the table up here, and the trophy will reside at the winner's school until next year. The top two finishers will represent Fauquier County. Here's the cup. Pretty big, isn't it? What do you think? Yeah, pretty cool. For your school. The top two finishers will represent Fauquier County on Saturday, March 11th at the Regional B in Fredericksburg. I want to say that there is a program error that we found. Shannon Anderson is in fourth grade at Greenville Elementary. Please note that. And I'd like to invite John to explain challenge issues and after B issues, including final round rules and the need for us to have two finalists.
Judges will consider it and will make the decision as to whether they feel that it is a valid challenge or whether they're going to reject it. objected, but that decision has to be made by the end, or the beginning of the next round. So we need to make it right away. So if you have a question or concern about a word, you can fill this out now. As far as what happens on a protest form, they can decide that they throw the word out. They can decide that they can sign another word, or they can decide that the challenge is not a valid challenge and the round continues. They will not eliminate a different question, a different participant on the challenge. So it has to be about the person who is spelling at the time. Let's see. Regarding the end of the procedures, when we get down to the two or three participants, things do change a little bit with how we run the rounds. Usually they run a little faster, obviously. And when we get down to two participants, let's say we're going through a round, first student misses the word, the second student spells the word correctly. The B is not officially over. It's not over until there is another round, and that second student that spelled the word correctly spells another word correctly. If they miss that next word, then both the students that were in the previous round come back into play for the next round. So we will have, we'll hear me say, potential winning word. That means that one of the students has an advantage over the other in the round, and they still need to spell one more word correctly in order to be declared a champion. Our champion and our first runner-up both go to our regional spelling bee because we have more than 10 schools participating in the spelling bee. So they both need to come up and see me at the end of the fee to get a picture taken from the that's who sponsors the region, and also the school commission so they can use the newspaper.
Did you tell them to exit from that side of the stage? Okay. Spellers, when we get to the end of the round, if you've missed a word, you'll be exiting the stage that way. Please be really careful. The stairs are steep when you go down that way. Okay, good morning, everyone. It's my pleasure to be the pronouncer for this year's Spelling Bee. I want to explain to the spellers and to the audience how a spelling bee differs from a spelling test. If you're the parent or the family members of a speller, you probably know that there were some word lists that the children were practicing. A spelling bee is different from a spelling test in that any word from the Webster's Third International Dictionary could appear on my list. So it's very random. They were given words to look at. Maybe some of those words appear in the bee. Maybe they don't. So it's not like we're going to study Thursday night for a Friday spelling test and we know all the words. The children don't know the words that they're about to get. They don't know what those words are going to be. And that adds a level of excitement to the bee. So they are completely random. Mr. Lucas pulled names, random order, to put the children on the stage, so the word that they get is just completely random. Random from the list, random from the order that they appear on the stage. So in our first round, we're just going to ask all the spellers, as Mr. Lucas said, to come up and spell your name, get used to the microphone, and then we'll get going. Ready?
Mikey, M-I-K-E-Y, Mikey.
Just say your first name and spell it, please.
Melody, M-E-L-O-D-Y.
Good.
Morgan, M-O-R-G-A-N, Morgan. M-I-N, Marin. Aaron, A-A-R-O-N, Aaron.
Imani, I-M-A-N-I.
Georgia, G-E-O-R-G-I-A, Georgia. Ruth, R-U-T-H, Ruth. Travis, T-R-A-V-I-S. Olivia, O-L-I-V-I-A. Frank, F-R-A-N-K, Frank.
Jake, J-A-K-E.
Joseph, J-O-S-E-P-H, Joseph. Gracie, G-R-A-C-I-E, Gracie.
Sadie, S-A-D-I-E, Sadie.
Amy, A-M-Y, Amy. Tammy, T-A-M-M-Y. Shannon, S-H-A-N-N-O-N.
Sean, S-E-A-N, Sean.
Nicholas, N-I-C-O-L-A-S, Nicholas. Marissa, M-A-R-I-S-S-A. Amaya, A apostrophe M-Y-A.
Owen, O-W-E-N, Owen.
Grace, G-R-A-C-E, Grace.
Ricardo, R-I-C-A-R-D-O.
Abigail, A-B-I-G-A-I-L. Caroline, C-A-R-O-L-I-N-E, Caroline. Jack, J-A-C-K, Jack.
Reef, R-E-E-F, Reef.
Javier, J-A-V-I-E-R, Javier. Sam, S-A-M, Sam. Lily, L-I-L-Y, Lily.
Luis, L-U-I-S.
Rhett. R-H-E-T-T, Rhett.
Jason, J-A-S-O-N, Jason.
Andy, A-N-D-Y, Andy. Sage, S-A-G-E, Sage. Muriel, M-I-R-I-E-L, Muriel. Juliana, J-U-L-I-A-N-A. Adriana, A-D-R-I-A-N-A, Adriana. Allie, A-L-I, Allie. Michelle, M-I-C-H-E-L-L-E.
Kelly, K-E-L-L-Y, Kelly.
Georgia, G-E-O-R-G-I-A, Georgia. Christian, C-H-R-I-S-T-I-A-N, Christian.
Sydney, S-Y-D-N-E-Y.
Okay, that's the end of round one. Woo! And we will ask you to, as difficult as it is, to hold your applause till the end of each round. It's exciting to applaud a correct one, but we want to keep the round moving. Spellers, while it's not required that you pronounce the word after I do, it's really a good idea that you do that, because if I ascertain that you haven't heard me correctly, I'll pronounce it again until you hear what it is that I'm saying. Okay? Yes. Question? A definite first and second place, third place, yes. Yes. We will know definitely. Okay. Some of the words that are on the list might be proper nouns, and of course proper nouns have a capital letter, but it's not necessary for you to say capital letters or hyphens or exclamation mark, or not exclamation marks, accent marks. It's not required to do that. The only thing that's required is that you say all the letters correctly in the correct order. If you decide to start over again, you get stuck in the middle and you want to go back to the beginning, you may start over again, but you can't change any letter that you already said. Yes. It's kind of like in cards, a card laid is a card played. Once you say a letter, you're there. You're committed to that. Okay? Now, please pronounce the word after me if you remember to do that. And don't walk away from the mic while you're still spelling. Some of you did that a little bit when you were spelling your name, like you were ready to sit down and you're still talking. Stay at the mic so that the judges can hear you, and try to face the judges, because sometimes They need to see how your mouth is forming the letter to make sure they heard the difference between, say, an M and an N or something like that. It helps if they can see your face, okay? Any other questions before we start?
Nope.
You good? All right, you got this. Your word is trek.
Trek. T-R-E. Can I start over?
You may.
May I have the definition?
The definition? Trek is a trip or movement, especially when involving difficulties or complex organization. Trek.
Language of origin?
Language of origin is originally Dutch that passed into Afrikaans.
Trek. T-R-E-K.
Trek.
Correct. Your word is waltz. Waltz.
Can I have the definition, please?
Yes. A waltz is a round dance in three-quarter time with a strong accent on the first beat of the measure that is characterized by one step to the beat, typically executed with a constant gyrating motion at a moderately fast tempo. Waltz.
Can I hear the origin, please?
It is from an originally German word.
Waltz. W-A-L-T-Z?
Correct. Your word is diary. Diary.
Diary. D-I-A-R-Y. Diary.
Correct. You're the first speller to get a homonym, and whenever there's a homonym, I'm going to tell you that, and I'm going to automatically give you the definition so that you know what homonym we're talking about, okay? And I'll also give you the part of speech. So the word is croon, croon. It is a verb, and croon means to sing in half voice, especially into a closely held microphone. Croon.
Croon. C-R-O-O-N. Croon.
Correct. Your word is tornado. Tornado.
Tornado. T-O-R-N-A-D-O. Tornado.
Correct. Your word is daily. Daily.
Daily. D-A-I-L-Y.
Correct. Your word is monsoon. Monsoon.
Monsoon. M-O-N-S-U-N-E. Monsoon.
I'm sorry. The correct spelling of monsoon is M-O-N-S-O-O-N. Your word is loiter, loiter.
Loiter, L-O-I-T-E-R, loiter.
Correct. Your word is muskrat, muskrat.
Muskrat, M-U-S-C-K-R-A-T, muskrat.
I'm sorry, it's M-U-S-K-R-A-T. Your word is dogged, dogged.
Dogged, D-O-G-G-E-D, dogged.
Correct. Your word is nosiest. Nosiest.
Noisiest.
No. Nosiest.
Nosiest. N-O-S-I-E-S-T.
Correct. Your word is mammoth. Mammoth.
Mammoth? Kind of language of origin?
Yes, this is a word, perhaps Yakut-derived Russian name. Mammoth.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
No alternate pronunciations.
Kind of definition?
Yes. Mammoth means gigantic.
Mammoth. M-A-M-M-O-T-H, mammoth?
Correct. Your word is womanly. Womanly.
Womanly. Can you repeat it?
Womanly.
Womanly. W-O-M-E-N-L-Y. Womanly.
I'm sorry. It's W-O-M-A-N-L-Y. Your word is learned. Learned.
Can I have the definition, please?
Learned is an adjective. It means well-informed, skilled, or practiced in a specific field. Learned.
Can I have the language of origin, please?
It's originally English.
Learned. L-E-A-R-N-E-D. Learned.
Correct. Your word is Netherlander. Netherlander.
Netherlander. N-E-T-H-E-R-L-A-N-D-E-R. Netherlander.
Correct. Your word is aspen. Aspen.
Aspen. A-S-P-I-N. Aspen.
I'm sorry, it's A-S-P-E-N. Your word, excuse me, your word is dreary, dreary.
Dreary, D-R-E-A-R-Y, dreary.
Correct. Your word is ballerina.
Ballerina, B-A-L-L-E-R-I-N-A, ballerina.
Correct. Your word is Capricorn. Capricorn.
Could I have the definition?
Capricorn is a noun. It's the 10th sign of the zodiac. Capricorn.
Capricorn. C A P R I C O R N. Capricorn.
Correct. Your word is fiend. Fiend.
Okay. Can I please have a definition of that?
Fiend is a person excessively devoted to or captivated by a pursuit, practice, or object of study. A fanatic. Fiend.
F-I-E-N-D, fiend.
Correct. Your word is nostril. Nostril.
Nostril. N-O-S-T-R-I-L.
Correct. Your word is caboose. Caboose.
Caboose. C-A... B-O-O-S-E, caboose.
Correct. Your word is dearth, dearth.
Dearth, D-U-R-T-H. A-R-T-H, dearth.
I'm sorry, it's D-E-A-R-T-H. Your word has a homonym. I'm going to provide the part of speech and the definition before you start to spell. The word is confidence. Confidence. It is a noun, and it means a relation or state of trust between persons who share or impart secrets or intimate matters. Confidence.
Confidence. C-O-N-F-I-D-E-N-C-E. Confidence.
Correct. Your word is sultan, sultan.
Sultan? Mm-hmm. Can I have a definition?
Yes, a sultan is a king or ruling sovereign, especially of an Islamic state. Sultan.
Sultan?
Sultan.
S-A-L-T-E-N?
I'm sorry, it's S-U-L-T-A-N, sultan. Your word is diorama, diorama.
Can I please have a definition?
Yes, a diorama is a noun. It's a scenic representation as of a theatrical stage in which sculptured figures and lifelike details are displayed, usually in miniature, so as to blend indistinguishably with a realistic painted background. Diorama.
Diorama. D-I-A. R-O-M-A, diorama.
No, I'm sorry, it's D-I-O-R-A-M-A, diorama. Your word is falsetto, falsetto.
May I have the definition, please?
Falsetto is a noun. It's an artificially high voice. Falsetto.
Falsetto. F-A-L-S-E-T-T-O. Falsetto.
Correct. Your word is geothermal. Geothermal.
Geothermal. G-E-O-T-H. E-R-M-A-L, geothermal.
Correct. Your word is crescent, crescent.
Crescent, C-R-E-S-C-E-N-T. Crescent.
Correct. Your word is a homonym. The word is llama. It is a noun, and it means any of several cud-chewing mammals of South America related to camels, but smaller and without a hump. Llama. Or it could be pronounced llama. Llama.
Llama. L-L-A-M-A.
Correct. Your word is gradient. Gradient.
Can you please repeat?
Yes. Gradient.
Gradient. G-R-A-D. Can I restart?
You may.
G-R-A-D-I-A-N-T.
I'm sorry, gradient. It's G-R-A-D-I-E-N-T. Your word is mathematics. Mathematics.
Mathematics. M-A-T-H-E-M-A-T-I-C-S.
M-A-T-I-C-S, mathematics.
Correct. Your word is harmonica.
Harmonica. Harmonica. H-A-R-M-O-N-I-C-A. Harmonica.
Harmonica, correct. Your word is stoic. Stoic.
Can I have the definition, please?
Yes. Stoic is an adjective. It means not affected by passion or feeling, especially manifesting indifference to pleasure or pain. Stoic.
Stoic. S-T-O-I-C. Stoic.
Correct. Your word is furlong. Furlong.
Can I have the definition, please?
Yes. Furlong is a noun. It means a unit of distance equal to 1/8 of a statute mile.
Language of origin, please.
It's originally English. Furlong.
Can you use it in a sentence, please?
I can. The horses named Katie's Delight and Going for Gold were neck and neck through the entire last furlong of the race.
Furlong. F-E-R-L-O-N-G. Furlong?
I'm sorry, it's F-U-R-L-O-N-G. Your word is hypothesis. Hypothesis.
Hypothesis. H-Y-P-O-T-H-E-S-I-S. Hypothesis.
Correct. Your word is ambulance. Ambulance.
Ambulance. A-M-B-U. L-A-N-C-E, ambulance.
Correct. Your word is contraband. Contraband.
Would you define that?
I would. Contraband is a noun. It means goods or merchandise, the importation, exportation, or sometimes possession of, which is forbidden. Contraband.
Contraband. C O N T R A B A N D. Contraband.
That is correct. Your word is hassock. Hassock.
Can you use it in a sentence, please?
Yes. Phyllis decided to purchase the wing chair with the matching hassock.
Can you please give me the definition?
The definition is a bulky upholstered cushion that serves as a seat or a leg rest. Hassock.
Hassock. H A S I C K. Hassock.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is H A S S O C K. Your word is seersucker. Seersucker.
Can you use that in a sentence?
Yes. Ben owns two suits made of seersucker.
Seal suckle. S-E-A-L-S-U-C-K.
I'm sorry, it's S-E-E-R-S-U-C-K-E-R. Your word is threshold.
Threshold. Threshold. Okay. Threshold. T-H-R-E-S-H-O-L-D. Threshold.
That is correct. Your word is spore, and it's a homonym, so I'm going to give you the whole definition. Spore. A mark as a footprint, trail, a scent, a sound, or droppings left by a wild animal that has passed by. Spore.
Spore. S-P-O-R-E. Spore.
I'm sorry, it's S-P-O-O-R. Your word is haversack, haversack.
Can I have the language of origin?
Originally German, this word became French before entering English. Haversack.
Haversack. H-A-V-E. R-S-A-C-K, haversack.
Correct. Your word could be confused with another word, a similar word, so I'm going to give you the definition so that you're sure that you understand me. The word is loam. Loam is a noun, and it means topsoil, usually fertile and humus-rich soil, consisting of a mixture of clay, silt, and sand. Loam.
Loam. L-O-M-E. Loam.
I'm sorry, it's L-O-A-M. Your word is Newton. Newton.
Newton. N-E-W-T-O-N, Newton.
Correct. Your word is hurricane. Hurricane.
Hurricane. H-U-R-R-I-C-A-N-E. Hurricane.
That is correct. And that's the end of the first round. Applause. This word has a near homonym. I will pronounce the word, give you the part of speech and the definition. The word is protein. It is, where's the part of speech here on my list? Noun. Of course, I should know that. Protein is a noun. I just want to make sure I'm reading what it says. It is any of a very large class of naturally occurring, extremely complex combinations of amino acids that are essential constituents of all living cells, and are also of the diet of the animal organism. Protein.
May I have the language of origin?
Yes, it is originally Greek, Greek-derived French element, plus an international scientific vocabulary element.
Protein. P-R-O-T-E-I-N.
Correct. Your word also could be confused with a similar word, so I'm going to provide the part of speech and definition. The word is maraca. It is a noun. A maraca is a rattle of Latin or American origin that is often made from a hollow gourd containing pebbles or dried seeds, and that is used as a percussion instrument, usually in pairs. Maraca.
Can I have the origin, please?
It is originally a Tupi word that has passed into the Portuguese. Maraca.
Can I have it in a sentence, please?
Yes. The band's percussionist accentuated the rhythm with a maraca.
Maraca. M-A-R-A-C-A. Maraca.
That is correct. Your word is Spartan. Spartan.
May I please have a definition?
Spartan is an adjective. It means marked by simplicity, frugality, avoidance of comfort and luxury, strict self-discipline, severity of manner, brevity in speech, and hardihood in the face of pain or danger. Spartan.
Spartan. S-P-A-R-T-A-N. Spartan.
That is correct. Your word is polymer. Polymer.
May I please have the definition?
Polymer is a noun. It means a natural or synthetic chemical compound or mixture of compounds consisting essentially of repeating structural units. Polymer.
Polymer. P-A-U-L-O-M-U-R. Polymer.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is P-O-L-Y-M-E-R. Your word is fathom. Fathom.
Fathom. F-A-T-H-O-M. Fathom.
That is correct. Your word is adios.
Adios, A-D-I-O-S.
Correct. Your word could be confused with a similar word, so I'm going to give you the part of speech and the definition, okay? The word is hector, hector. It is a verb, and it means to harass, intimidate, bully, or domineer over by bluster, scolding, or personal pressure. Hector.
Hector, H-E-C-T-E-R, Hector.
I'm sorry, it's H-E-C-T-O-R. Your word is algebra.
Algebra, A-L-G-E-B-R-A, algebra.
That is correct. Your word is sumo, sumo.
Sumo. S-U-M-O, sumo.
Correct. Your word is carnivore, carnivore.
Carnivore, can I have the definition?
Carnivore is a noun, and it means a flesh-eating animal. Carnivore.
Kind of language of origin?
It's from the Latin.
Carnivore. Are there any alternate pronunciations?
No alternate pronunciations for this one. Carnivore.
C-A-R-N-I-V-O-R-E. Carnivore.
Correct. Your word is giraffe. Giraffe.
Giraffe. G-I-R-A-F-F-E. Giraffe.
Correct. Your word is anchovy. Anchovy.
Anchovy. Can I have the definition?
Yes. Anchovy is a noun. It's any of a number of small herring-like fishes, especially a common Mediterranean form esteemed for its rich and peculiar flavor. Anchovy.
Anchovy. A-N-C-H-O-V-E. Anchovy.
I'm sorry, it's A-N-C-H-O-V-Y. Your word is crochet. Crochet.
Crochet. C-R-O-C-H-E-T, crochet?
Correct. Your word is hosta. Hosta.
Huh?
Hosta.
Hosta?
Hosta.
Okay, could you give me the definition?
Yes. Hosta is a noun. It means any plant of the genus of Asiatic perennial herbs that have ribbed leaves, often blotched or bordered with white, and scapes of blue or lilac flowers that are widely cultivated as ornamentals.
Hosta. H-O-S-T-A, hosta.
Correct. Your word is alamo. Alamo.
Can I have the definition?
Alamo is a noun, and it means a tree of the genus Populus, especially an aspen. Alamo.
Can I have the language of origin?
It's from Spanish.
Alamo. A L I M O, Alamo.
I'm sorry, it's A L A M O, Alamo. Your word is conjecture. Conjecture.
Conjecture. C O N J E C T U R E. Conjecture.
Correct. Your word is paddock. Paddock.
Could you please use it in a sentence?
Before the race, the trainer inspected the horse's condition inside the paddock.
Paddock. P-A-T-I-C, paddock.
I'm sorry, it's P-A-D-D-O-C-K, paddock. This word could be confused with a similar word, so I'm going to give you the pronunciation, the part of speech, and the definition before you begin spelling, okay? The word is canasta, canasta. It is a noun, and it means a card game that is a form of rummy, played usually as a two-hand or a four-hand partnership game using two full decks plus four jokers. Canasta.
Canasta. C-O-N-A-S-T-A, canasta.
I'm sorry, it's C-A-N-A-S-T-A. Canasta. Your word is hyphen. Hyphen.
Hyphen. H Y P H I E N. Hyphen.
I'm sorry, it's H Y P H E N. Your word is petunia. Petunia.
Petunia. P-E-T-U-N-I-A. Petunia.
Correct. Your word is antibiotic. Antibiotic.
Antibiotic. A N T I B I O T I C. Antibiotic.
Correct. Your word is mesa. Mesa.
Mesa. M-A-Y-S-A. Mesa.
I'm sorry, it's M-E-S-A. Mesa. Okay, your word could be confused with a similar word, so I'm going to give you the pronunciation and the definition. The word is lithe, lithe. It's an adjective, and it means agile and easily flexed or supple. Lithe.
Can you put it in a sentence?
Yes. Angela enjoyed watching lithe dancers in action. Am I perceiving flash? Please don't use flash while the children are spelling. It's very distracting.
Lithe.
Let me give you another chance here. Lithe. Lithe. Do you hear it? You hear it? Okay.
Lithe. L. I. V. Y. E. D.
I'm sorry, it's L-I-T-H-E, lithe. Your word is chronic, chronic.
Chronic, C-H-R-O-N-I-C, chronic.
Correct. Your word is fatigue, fatigue.
May you get the word of origin?
This word comes from French, which formed it from a Latin word, fatigue.
Fatigue. F-A-T-I-G-U-E, fatigue.
Correct. Your word is automaton, automaton.
Can I please have the definition?
Automaton is a noun. It means a contrivance or figure that appears to imitate the motions of humans or animals. A synonym would be robot, automaton.
Can I have the origin, please?
It's Greek.
Part of speech?
A noun.
Can you use it in a sentence?
Leonardo da Vinci designed an automaton that could ring a bell. Let me do it again. Automaton. Automaton.
Automaton. O T O M A T O N.
I'm sorry, it's A-U-T-O. M-A-T-O-N, automaton. Your word is Ramada, Ramada.
Country of origin?
This is a word that went from Latin to Spanish. Ramada.
Ramada. R-O-M-A-D-A, Ramada.
I'm sorry, it's R-A-M-A-D-A. Your word is bevel, bevel.
What does it mean?
It means cut or shaped into an angle to put a slant on the edge of it. Bevel.
Bevel. B-E-V-E-L?
Correct.
Oh, yay. Actually,
your word is Olympian. Olympian.
What'd you define that?
Olympian means a being of lofty detachment or superior attainments. Olympian.
Olympian. O L Y M P I A N. Olympian.
Correct. Your word is androcentric. Androcentric.
Could I have a definition, please?
It's an adjective meaning centered, centering, or centered on, or in the male, dominated by, or emphasizing masculine interests or point of view. Androcentric.
Androcentric. A N D R O C E N T R I C.
Correct. Your word is linden. Linden.
Linden. Can I have the definition?
Linden is a noun. It's a tall forest tree of eastern and central North America. Linden.
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 L-I-N-D-E-N. Linden.
Correct. It's also a town in Fauquier County, but that's not on my sheet. Your word is graffiti. Graffiti.
Graffiti. G-R-A-F-I-T-T-I. Graffiti.
I'm sorry, it's G-R-A.
There's two F's. Isn't
two it? F's and one T, yeah. Sorry. Your word is vivisection. Vivisection.
Vivisection. V-I-V-I-S-E-C-T-I-O-N. Vivisection.
That is correct. All right, that's the end of round two. The word is Sierra.
Sierra. S-I-E-R-R-A. Sierra.
That is correct. Yes.
Oh, I fell off.
Good. Your word is condolences. Condolences.
Condolences. C-O-N-D-O-L-E-N-C-E-S. Condolences.
Correct. This word could be confused with a similar word, so I'm going to give you the definition along with the pronunciation. The word is salami. It's a noun, and it's a highly seasoned sausage made of pork and beef, salami.
Can I have the origin, please?
It came from Italian, which formed it from a Latin word.
Salami. S-A-L-A-M-I. Salami.
Correct. Your word is tortilla. Tortilla.
Tortilla. T-O-R-T-I-A.
I'm sorry, it's T-O-R-T-I-L-L-A, tortilla. Your word has a near homonym, so I'm going to give you the definition and the part of speech before you begin to spell. The word is lucid. Lucid is an adjective. It means having, manifested, or marked by full use of one's faculties, oriented, rational, or sane. Lucid.
Could you use it in a sentence?
Yes. The speaker at the black tie dinner sounded lucid even though he was wearing a rubber nose and a fright wig. Lucid.
Lucid. L-O-O-S-E-D. Lucid.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is L-U-C-I-D. Your word is morgue. Morgue.
Morgue.
Morgue.
M-O-R-G-U-E.
Correct. Your word is cosmos. Cosmos.
Cosmos. C O S M O S. Cosmos.
Correct. Your word is folksiness. Folksiness.
Folksiness. F-O-C-I-N-U-S. Folksiness.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is F-O-L-K-S-I-N-E-S-S. Your word is stipple. Stipple.
Kind of language of origin?
The word is a Dutch word, stipple.
Stipple, S-T-I-P-P-L-E, stipple.
Correct. Your word is fresco, fresco.
Can I have the definition, please?
Fresco is a noun. It means the art of painting on freshly spread moist lime plaster with pigments suspended in a water vehicle. Fresco.
Fresco. F-R-E-S-C-O. Fresco.
Correct. Your word is excise. Excise.
Excise. E. C. X. I. S. E. Excise.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is E. X. C. I. S. E. Your word is popularity. Popularity.
Popularity. P. O. P. U. L. A. R. I-T-Y, popularity.
Correct. Your word is spritz. Spritz.
Could you please use that in a sentence?
Monica used a spritz of hairspray to keep her bangs out of her face. Spritz.
Could I have a definition?
Spritz means a spray or a squirt.
Spritz. S-P-R-I-T-Z, spritz.
Correct. Your word is Melba. Melba.
Can you please use that in a sentence?
The peach Melba was served in a crystal goblet. Melba.
Melba. M-E-L-B-A. Melba.
Correct. Your word is biblical. Biblical.
Biblical. B I B L I C A L. Biblical.
Correct. Your word could be confused with a different word, so I'm going to go ahead and give you the definition before you begin to spell. The word is pundit. Pundit. It's a noun. A pundit is an authority or one who announces judgments, opinions, or conclusions in an authoritative manner. A critic. Pundit.
Pundit. P-U-N-D-E-T-T. Pundit.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is P-U-N-D-I-T, pundit. Your word is hogan or hogan.
Can I have the definition, please?
The word is a noun, and it is a conical, hexagonal, or octagonal dwelling characteristic of the Navajo, made with a door traditionally facing east and constructed of logs and sticks covered with mud, sod, or adobe, or sometimes stones. Hogan.
Hogan. H-O-G-A-N. Hogan.
Correct. Your word is credible. Credible.
Credible. C-R-E-D-I-B-L-E. Credible.
Correct. I'm going to give you the definition of this word just to make sure that we're clear. The word is trawl. Trawl. It's a large conical net with a device for keeping its mouth open that is dragged along the sea bottom in gathering fish or other marine life. Trawl.
Trawl. T-R-A-W-L. Trawl.
Correct. Your word is ambiguity. Ambiguity.
Where do you define that?
Ambiguity is the condition of admitting of two or more meanings, of being understood in more than one way, or of referring to two or more things at the same time. Ambiguity.
Ambiguity. A M B I G U I T Y.
Correct. Your word is diagnosis. Diagnosis.
Okay. Could I have the definition, please?
Diagnosis is a noun, the art or act of identifying a disease from its signs and symptoms. Also, the decision reached. Diagnosis.
Diagnosis. D-I-A-G-N-O-S-I-S. Diagnosis.
Correct. Your word is enchilada. Enchilada.
Enchilada. Enchilada. E N C H I L A D A. Enchilada?
Correct. Your word is acronym. Acronym.
Acronym. A C R I N I M. Acronym.
I'm sorry, it's correct. Spelling is A C R O N Y M. And that's the end of this round, round three. We're going to begin round four. There we go. Your word is libretto. Libretto.
Okay. Libretto. L-I-B-R-E-T-T-O. Libretto.
Correct. Your word is orthodox. Orthodox.
Can I have the definition, please?
Orthodox is an adjective. It means marked by conformity to doctrines or practices, especially in religion, that are held as right or true by some authority, standard, or tradition. Orthodox.
Can I hear the origin, please?
Both parts of the word are originally Greek. Orthodox.
Can you use it in a sentence, please?
An Orthodox believer, Maria was dismayed by the novel The Da Vinci Code, even though it is a fictional work. Orthodox.
Orthodox. O-R-T-H-O-D-O-X. Orthodox.
Correct. Castanets. Castanets.
Castanets. C-A-S-T-A-N-E-T-S.
Correct. Your word is boudoir. Boudoir.
Boudoir. B O O-D-W-A-R, boudoir.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is B-O-U-D-O-I-R, boudoir. Your word is desperado. Desperado.
Desperado?
Desperado.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There is desperado.
Desperado. What's the definition?
The definition is a bandit of the Western frontier, desperado.
Can I have the language of origin, please?
It is a word that went from Latin to Spanish.
Desperado. D-E-S-P-E-R-A-D-O, desperado.
Correct. Your word is geisha. Geisha.
The definition, please.
It is a noun, and it's a Japanese girl who is trained to provide entertaining and lighthearted company as for a man or a group of men. Geisha.
Can you use it in a sentence, please?
The geisha entertained her client with music and dance.
Geisha. G-A-I-S-H-A, geisha.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is G-E-I-S-H-A, geisha. Your word is Argentine. Argentine.
Argentine. A-R-G-E-N-T-I-N-E, Argentine.
Correct. Your word is eponym, eponym.
Could you please use that in a sentence?
Johann Zinn, a German botanist, was the eponym for the flower we know as zinnia.
Can I have a definition?
An eponym is one for whom or which something is named or supposedly named. Eponym.
E-P-I-N-E-M, eponym.
I'm sorry, it's E-P-O-N-Y-M. Your word is obsequious. Obsequious.
May I have the definition?
Obsequious is an adjective, and it means meanly or servilely attentive, compliant to excess. Obsequious.
May I have the language of origin?
This is a word that went from Latin to English. Obsequious.
Obsequious. O-B-S-E-Q-U-I-O-U-S?
Correct. Your word is hydraulic. Hydraulic.
Hydraulic. H-Y-D-R-A-U-L-I-C. Hydraulic.
That is correct. This word could be confused with a similar word, so I'm going to provide you with the definition and the part of speech. The word is incognito. It's an adverb, and it means with one's identity concealed or assumed to be concealed. Incognito.
Incognito. I-N-C-O-G-N-I-T-O. Incognito.
That is correct. Your word is matriarch. Matriarch.
Matriarch. Can you use it in a sentence, please?
Yes. The family plans to hold a gala celebration on the 90th birthday of its matriarch.
Matriarch. M A T R I A R C. Matriarch.
M A T R I A R C H. Your word is aristocracy.
Aristocracy. A R I S T O C R A C Y. Aristocracy.
Correct. Your word is vogue. Vogue.
Would you define that?
Vogue is popular acceptance or favor, popularity. It's a noun, vogue.
Vogue. V-O-U-G-E. Vogue.
I'm sorry. It's V-O-G-U-E. Your word is cadenza. Cadenza.
Could I have a definition, please?
Cadenza is a noun, and it means a parenthetic flourish in the course of an aria or other solo piece, commonly just before the final or other important chord sequence. Cadenza.
Could I have the language of origin?
Yes. It is from Italian, which formed it from a Latin word.
Okay.
Cadenza.
C-A-D-E. C-E-N-Z-A, cadenza.
That is correct. Your word is misanthropy.
Is it misanthropy?
Yeah.
My parents are so proud of me.
Yeah. It's got two different places of putting the accent. Yeah.
What does it mean?
It's a misanthropy means a hatred of humankind, a distrust of human nature.
Okay, that's the one.
Yep, that's the one. Sorry.
Okay. No, that's all right. Misanthropy. MISANTHROPY, misanthropy.
That is correct. And that's the end of the round. Okay, first word of round five. The word is tortoni. Tortoni.
Tortoni. T-O-R-T-O-N-I. Tortoni.
Correct. Semolina. Your word is semolina.
Can I hear the definition, please?
Yes. Semolina is the purified middlings of durum or other hard wheat used for making pasta. Semolina.
Can I hear the origin, please?
The word came from Italian, which formed it from a Latin word.
Can you use it in a sentence, please?
It is often said that the best pasta is made from semolina.
Semolina. S-E-M-A-L-I-N-A. Semolina.
I'm sorry, it's S-E-M-O-L-I-N-A. Your word has a homonym, so I'm going to give you the definition before you begin to spell. The word is con. It is a noun, and it means a rest house in some Asian countries where caravans rest at night. That is commonly a large bare building surrounding a court. Khan.
Khan. K-H. Can I have the language of origin, please?
The word is from French, of Turkic origin. Khan.
K-H. O-N.
I'm sorry, it's K-H-A-N. Your word is chalupa. Chalupa.
Chalupa? Mm-hmm. Are there alternate pronunciations?
Chalupa.
Kind of language of origin, please?
It is a word that was taken from French but passed through the Spanish before becoming English. Chalupa.
Chalupa. C-H-A-L-U-P-A. Chalupa?
Correct. Your word is fennel. Fennel.
Fennel? Can I have the definition, please?
Fennel is a noun. It's a perennial European herb, not native to North America, and cultivated for the aromatic flavor of its seeds. Fennel.
Okay. F-E-N-N-E-L. Fennel.
Correct. Your word is piazza, piazza.
May I have the definition, please?
It's a noun. It means an open square in a town, piazza.
May I have the language of origin?
This word came from Italian, which formed it from a Latin word.
Piazza, P-I-A-Z-Z-A, piazza.
Correct. Your word could be confused with another word, so I'm going to pronounce it and give you the part of speech and the definition. The word is corporal, corporal. It is an adjective, and it means affecting, related to, or belonging to the body, corporal.
Corporal. C-O-R-P-O-R-O-L.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is C-O-R-P-O-R-A-L. Your word also could be confused with another word, so I'm going to give you the definition. Your word is rotunda. Rotunda is a noun. Your word is a noun. It means a round building, especially one that is round both outside and inside, and is covered by a dome. Rotunda.
Rotunda. R-O-T-U-N-D-A, rotunda.
Correct. Your word is Satori, Satori.
What is the language of origin?
Japanese.
Okay. Satori. S-A-T-O-R-I, Satori.
Correct.
Oh.
Your word is adamant. Adamant.
Could I have the definition, please?
Adamant is an adjective. It means inflexible or insistent, especially in maintaining a position or opinion. Adamant.
Adamant. A D A M E N T.
I'm sorry, it's A D A M A N T. Your word is scenario or scenario.
Scenario. Can I have the language of origin?
The word is originally from Greek and it passed into Latin.
Scenario. S-C-E-N-A-R-I-O. Scenario?
Correct. And that's the end of the round. Congratulations. Okay, we're ready for round six. Your word is tantalize, tantalize.
Origin?
It is from a Greek literary name, tantalize.
Tantalize, T-A-N-T-A-L-I-Z-E, tantalize.
Correct. Your word is alleviate, alleviate.
Alleviate?
Alleviate.
Can I have alternate pronunciations?
No alternate pronunciations for this word. Alleviate.
Language of origin?
Latin.
Alleviate. A-L-L-E-V-I-A-T-E. Alleviate?
Correct. This word has a close, similar word, and I'm going to make sure to define it before you begin to spell. The word is cavalry. Cavalry is a noun, and it means the component of an army that maneuvers and fights on horseback. Cavalry.
Cavalry. C-A-V-A-L-R-Y. Cavalry.
Correct. Your word is harpsichord. Harpsichord.
May I have language of origin?
It comes from Italian, which formed it from a Latin word. Harpsichord.
Harpsichord. H-A-R-P-S-I-C-H-O-R-D. Harpsichord.
Correct. Your word is amnesia. Amnesia.
Amnesia. A-M-N-E-S-I-A. Amnesia.
Correct. Your word is Kremlin. Kremlin.
Language of origin?
Russian.
Okay. I think I know it. C. Oh. No, it was K.
I'm sorry. It was K, R-E-M-L-I-N. Your word is arsenal. Arsenal.
Arsenal. Can I have it in a sentence?
In early 1941, Franklin D. Roosevelt believed that the most immediate role of the United States was to act as an arsenal for democratic nations.
It's the language of origin.
Originally Arabic, this word went into Italian before being adopted by English.
Arsenal.
Arsenal.
Arsenal. A-R-S-E-N-A-L. Arsenal?
Correct. Okay, that's the end of round six. Your word is mongrel. Mongrel.
Origin, please.
Originally English.
Mongrel.
Mongrel.
Mm-hmm. Mongrel. M-O-N-G-R-I-L. Mongrel.
Sorry, it's M-O-N-G-R-E-L. Mongrel. Mm-hmm. Your word is syntax. Syntax.
Syntax?
Syntax.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
No, not to this one.
Can I have the language of origin?
The word is a word that came from Greek to French to Latin.
Syntax. S-Y-N-T-A-X, syntax?
Correct. Your word is trajectory.
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 T-R-A-J-E-C-T-O-R-Y. Trajectory.
Correct. This word has a near homonym, so I'm going to give you the definition. The word is vulcanize. Vulcanize is a verb, and it means to subject various materials as for hardening to a process of treating in any of various ways. Vulcanize.
May I have the origin?
It's a word that consists of a Latin literary name plus an English combining form. Vulcanize.
Vulcanize. V-O-L-C-A-N-I-Z-E. Vulcanize.
I'm sorry. It's V-U-L-C-A-N-I-Z-E. Your word is relevant. Relevant.
Relevant. R E L E V A N T. Relevant?
Correct. Your word is musicale. Musicale.
Musicale. Can I have the language of origin?
It's a French word. It's from a French word.
Can I have it in a sentence?
the governor's mansion was the site of a well-attended musicale celebrating New Year's Day.
Not so sure about this. Musicale. M-U-S-I-C-A-L-E, musicale?
Correct.
Whoa!
Okay.
Alternate pronunciations?
No alternate pronunciations.
Language of origin?
Originally Latin, this word went through French before becoming English.
Emperor. E-M-P-E-R-O-R, emperor?
Correct. Your word has a near homonym, so I'm going to give you the definition.
Okay.
The word is oracle.
Oracle.
It's a noun. It means a person of great authority or wisdom whose opinions or judgments are regarded with great respect. Oracle.
Okay. Oracle. O-R-I-C-A-L-E. Oracle.
I'm sorry. The correct spelling is O-R-I-C-A-L-E. A-C-L-E. Your word is zodiac. Zodiac.
Zodiac. Z-O-D-I-A-C. Zodiac.
Correct. Your word is prosthetic.
Prosthetic. Can I have the word of origin?
It's from Greek.
Tedious process this is. Can I have it in a sentence?
Nico had to learn to walk again with a prosthetic right foot after losing his in an accident. Prosthetic.
Prosthetic. P-R-O-S. T-H-E-T-I-C, prosthetic.
Correct. Okay. This is round 9. Your word is nonviolent.
Nonviolent?
Nonviolent.
The language of origin?
Both parts of this word went from Latin to French to English.
Are there alternate pronunciations?
No.
Can I have definition?
Definition is not done with the use of physical force, peaceful, nonviolent.
Nonviolent. N-O-N-V-I-O-L-E-N-T, nonviolent?
Correct. Your word is artillery. Artillery.
Artillery. A-R-T-I-L-L-E-R-Y. Artillery.
Correct. Your word is treatise. Treatise.
Treatise?
Treatise.
Can I have the language of origin?
This word is probably from an originally French word that went through Anglo-French to English. Treatise.
Treatise?
Treatise.
Can I have the definition?
A treatise is a piece of writing that provides a thorough and careful discussion or argument about a subject.
Treatise. T-R-E T-R-E-A-T-U-S, treatise?
Sorry, it's T-R-E-A-T-I-S-E. Sorry. Good job. Your word is antidote. Antidote.
Language of origin?
Originally Greek, this word went into Latin before becoming English.
Antidote. A-N-T-I-D-O-T-E. Antidote.
Correct. Your word is servitude. Servitude.
Servitude. S-E-R. V-I-T-U-D-E, servitude.
Correct. Yay, that's the end of round 10. Okay. Hang on one second. Okay.
Language of origin?
It is from Latin.
Have definition?
Derelict means forgotten or run down.
Derelict. Can you repeat the word?
Derelict.
Derelict. D-A-R-A-L-I-C-T?
I'm sorry, that is not correct. The correct spelling is D-E-R-E-L-I-C-T. But stay put. Your word is charismatic. Charismatic.
Charismatic. C H A R I S M A T I C. Charismatic.
That is correct. Now, Stay on. That's the end of round 11. Now, and we need to have you spell one more word correctly. And this word has a near homonym. I'm going to give you the definition before you begin to spell. The word is sentries, sentries. And sentries are soldiers standing guard. Sentries.
Sentries. S-E-N-T-R-I-E-S, sentries.
We have a winner. Dr. Jack, would you like to present the trophy? Dr. David Jack is going to present the trophy along with Mr. Bland and Mr. Gorg. It's very nice. And our winner is Lily von Herbulis. And second place is Jake Goldman. They will both advance to the Regional B. We are extraordinarily proud of all of our spellers. Thank you all for coming.
Now what are you going to do with it?
Okay, do the parents of the winners want to come up and be photographed with their spellers?
Come on, Daddy.
Daddy, come on up.
You have to smile.
A round of applause for Dr. Berguin for pronunciation.
Thank you. Thank you. My pleasure.
Congratulations.